Today's top three tech giants, that is Amazon, Microsoft and Google, have their own cloud platforms out there. And their names are Amazon Web Services, Microsoft Azure and Google Cloud Platform. Hey guys, this is Shubham from IntelliPath. And in this video, I'm going to compare three of these cloud giants and discuss which one to choose. So without any further delays, let's get started. Let us just start from the basic and discuss each service in a brief. Amazon Web Services is the oldest and the most experienced player in the market, as it was established at the beginning of 2006. AWS has an extensive list of computing services with functions of deployments, mobile networking, databases, storage, security, and many more. Whereas Microsoft Azure was presented in February 2010, and since then it has shown a great promise among its rivals. This platform can easily be associated with AWS, and both provide their customers with a full set of services in the domains of compute, storage, database, networking, and many more, just like AWS. On the other hand, Google Cloud Platform began their journey on October 6, 2011, and by this time they have managed to create a good presence in the industry. Initially, the push was to strengthen their own services such as Google or YouTube, but now they have moved further and they have also created the enterprise's services. So now anyone can use their cloud platform, which shares the same infrastructure that of Google Search and YouTube. But still, the question remains, how are these three cloud services different, and what are the factors that we need to focus on while comparing three of these services? Well, we are about to discuss that as we move forward. Let's just start from the first factor, that is the availability zones. Before discussing this factor, let me give you a brief introduction to availability zones. Availability zones are the isolated locations within data centers regions from which public cloud services originate and operate, and the regions are the geographic locations in the data centers where public cloud service providers reside. Basically, businesses which are using cloud choose one or multiple worldwide availability zones for their services depending on their business needs. So they select the availability zones for a variety of reasons, including compliance and providing proximities to end customers. Cloud administrators can also choose to replicate services across multiple availability zones to decrease latency as well as to protect their resources. Admins can move their resources to another availability zones in the event of blackout. Certain cloud services may also be limited to particular regions or availability zones. So now, we are all aware of their establishments. We all know that AWS was the first one of its kind, right? Which means AWS is hosting in multiple locations worldwide. And of course, it is true for Azure as well as for Google. But here also, the difference occurs in the numbers of regions and availability zones. Talking of number, AWS has 55 availability zones worldwide, with 8 more on its way. Whereas Azure is having 44 availability zones with a whooping number of 12 more on the way. On the other hand, Google is having 18 availability zones with a 3 more on the way, which is no doubt is quite a lesser number than AWS and Azure. Now let's move forward and talk about the next factor, which is the market share. So guys, if you check this graph right here, which clearly depicts that how AWS is leading with 40% of public cloud market shares worldwide on its name, whereas Azure is on the second place with 30% of the market share, and Google Cloud, which is not that behind, is on third place with 10% of the market share, and other cloud providers combines at 20% of it. And guys, let me tell you an interesting fact here, that according to a recent report by KeyBank, Amazon lost almost 6% share while Microsoft Azure moved from 26% to 30%, and Google successfully jumped its share from 8% to 10% in the cloud business. Also, if you check the Google Trends graph and compare their popularity, these are the stats where you can easily figure out that how interest for AWS has been surpassing, with Azure on second place and Google on the third. Worldwide in the past 12 months. Even if we check the research results and trends according to USA, same cases here as well, where there is more interest for AWS than Azure and Google Cloud. In case of India, here are the results. Still, AWS is more trending. These are the results from past 12 months and have been varying and relatively increasing, with AWS on the first and Azure on second, Google Cloud on third from a past decade. We are all aware about the establishment of AWS now as a first cloud provider, right? And with the more experience and implementation in the cloud domain, it obviously has a bigger community support and trust across its clients. And with Azure and Google Cloud, well, they have been able to cop up trust across their multiple clients successfully. So let's check what type of companies are using them. AWS is having more profile customers like Netflix, Airbnb, BMW, Unilever, Samsung, Xiaomi, Zynga, etc. And Azure is also not that behind us. Almost 80% of Fortune 500 companies have put their faith in Azure recently. recently. Some of its major clients are Johnson Controls, Polycom, Fujifilm, HP, Honeywell, Apple, etc. Since Google shares the same infrastructure that of Google search engine and YouTube, that is why many huge companies are having faith on them. And some of their major clients are HSBC, PayPal, 20th Century Fox, Bloomberg, Target, Domino's, etc. No doubt, AWS is dominating public cloud over Microsoft Azure and Google in this race, but they both are also growing continuously to be at the top. So guys, don't you think it is quite impressive for Azure and Google to be on the top runner list even after being a latecomer in the cloud domain? Right. Now, after discussing their establishment in the market, let's talk about what each provider has to offer in terms of services. So guys, the services which I'm going to compare here are very primary and comes under the following domains. That is the compute, database, storage, troubleshooting, and monitoring. So AWS covers like 200 plus services and Azure also covers 100 plus of it. Whereas Google Cloud have been catching up with it with a number of 60 plus services. So now let us compare the primary services in each of these domains. I'm not covering all of these services since there are so many services in each of these domains. So in the compute domain, the primary service offered by AWS is EC2. In Azure, it's Virtual Machine and Cloud Engine for Google. So basically all these three services help you in launching instance on cloud. Like if you want to run a virtual machine or an operating system without an on-premise infrastructure, you can do so with any of these services. They all have the same idea, same working with the same functionality. Just the names are different. But there is one major difference, that is the speed of launching an instance. Well, if you try to launch an instance in three of them, AWS will take around a minute to launch an instance. In case of Azure, it takes more time to do so. But guys, in case of Google Cloud Platform, well, it takes seconds to launch an instance. This is where Compute Engine comes out to be a preferable choice. Now, another service comes under database domain. Primary database service provided by AWS is RDS. That is a relational database service where the databases like MySQL, MariaDB, Oracle, which can be managed automatically, like backup, security patches, and updates are done automatically by RDS. In case of Azure, there is a primary service called as SQL Database Service. Well, in this service, you cannot choose any like MariaDB, Oracle, or MySQL databases. So you can only choose SQL database. And you need to change your application code to be compatible with SQL databases if you are using Azure. Even you have to configure everything on your own. No automated updates facilities here. Now in case of Google, we have the service named as SQL Database, wherein you don't have the provision of choosing any other database apart from MySQL database and PostgreSQL. Now let's discuss the next domain, that is the storage domain. The primary service in AWS storage is S3. So this is the simple storage service, which is an object-based file system. So whenever you are storing your file on these system, these files can be treated as an object, and S3 consists of buckets, which further consist of root folder, and one can store their objects inside these root folders. And Azure on the other hand implemented this similar idea. It's primary storage service named as Blob Storage, which is an object-based file system where the files are stored as an object. Well, in case of Google, Cloud Storage is a service, and again which provides you the similar kind of object-based storage system. Moving forward with the another domain, that is the troubleshooting. The primary service provided by AWS is CloudTrail. CloudTrail is a logging service. Any deployed apps on AWS with the API calls, those API calls gets recorded in the logs of AWS, and then it helps you to troubleshoot your application. Suppose if there is an error, you can easily troubleshoot the specific part of that failure in your application. Such operations can be done using the logs which gets stored in your AWS. And in case of Azure, you have Azure Operational Insights, which provides you the similar service that of AWS if you have your application deployed on Azure with the API calls. Similarly, in case of GCP, we have Stack Driver Logging, which again provides you the same functionalities. Our next and last domain is monitoring. Well, in case of monitoring, the only service offered by AWS is CloudWatch. Using this service, you can easily monitor each and every resource or service running in your AWS account. It provides you very basic information like the amount of traffic coming to your instance, what kind of traffic is connecting to your instance, the performance of your instance, etc. You can manage, control, and monitor all of them using AWS CloudWatch. And Azure, on the other hand, provides you a similar service called as Azure Application Insight, which does the exact and same operation just like AWS CloudWatch. Also, Google provides you Stack Driver Monitoring Service, which again performs the same and exact operation that of AWS CloudWatch. Now, the another factor is its downtime. Having a matured infrastructure, the maximum downtime faced by AWS in 2014 was of 2 hours and 69 minutes. And whereas in case of Azure, even after having a good infrastructure, they faced a huge downtime of 39.77 hours. And Google, on the other hand, just faced a downtime of 14 minutes and resumed its services in no time, which is actually impressive for a newcomer like Google Cloud Platform. Now let's move ahead and check their pricing and billing models. In case of AWS, a very basic instance which includes two virtual CPUs and 8 GB of RAM will cost you around $69 per month. In case of Azure, it will cost you around $70 per month. And when compared to GCP with 25% cheaper rate, it will cost you around $52 per month. Now the largest instance offered by AWS is of 3.84 TB of RAM along with 128 virtual CPUs, which will cost you around $3.97 per hour. Azure, on the other hand, offers 3.89 TB along with 128 virtual CPUs, which costs you around $6.79 per hour. And in case of Google, this is where Google takes the lead, with a whooping number of 160 virtual CPUs with a 3.75 TB of RAM, which will cost you around $5.32 per hour, which I believe is much cheaper in terms of virtual CPUs provisioning as compared to AWS and Azure, right? Moving forward, AWS provides you reserved instances. For example, the company purchases the instance for contract prices, where instances are available in various levels of compute power. And if a company buys them for a particular year, like this could be for 1 to 3 years contract, then they will get a 70% discount. This is how it works, right? So now previously AWS used to charge on per hourly basis, but recently they launched the per minute basis billing as well. Because guys, during the hourly billing, it did not make sense for the people who were using the instances for like few minutes and they were charged for an hourly basis, right? So now in case of Azure, the same idea was implemented, and that is called as Microsoft Enterprise Agreement. You just need to reserve your instances using this service. And also Azure has been following the per minute basis billing from starting. In case of Google Cloud, they have committed use, wherein you reserve your instances for like 1 or 3 years contract, then they provide you better discount rates than Azure or AWS. And another billing model provided by GCP is the sustained use. In sustained use, you get discounts automatically if you keep using the same instance for the majority of the time. And also GCP has been following the per minute basis billing from starting. Now let's move forward. So which one you should choose and why? So guys, I'm not going to be biased here. I will just discuss the key takeaways for each one of them. If we talk about AWS, well, it dominates every cloud service when it comes to features like configuration, monitoring, security, auto scaling, etc. Another important aspect is that they have the mature infrastructure along with the better offerings. Due to more experience, they provide enterprise-friendly services, and more open source tools integration availability is here. And no doubt they have the global reach. In case of Azure, well, it is more reliable when it comes to integrating with Microsoft tools. And also it ranks first in development and testing tools. It provides hybrid cloud as well. Now for Google, since they are expertise in DevOps, so it integrates with majority of DevOps tools. They provide you flexible discounts and contracts as well. Google have specifically designed them for cloud-based businesses. Now let's discuss some of the factors on which we should not choose them. No doubt AWS is difficult to use, especially when you compare it with the ease of using Google Cloud. There are like overwhelming options for each domain, which actually ends up confusing the clients. And their cost management is not that good. In case of Azure, they provide you less efficient management tooling and they are less enterprise ready. In Google Cloud, since they entered late in IaaS market, so they have less data centers across the globe. Their services are good, but they have fewer services and features. So guys, who do you think is the winner here? AWS or Azure or Google Cloud? Well, most of you must have figured out from the above stats that how Google Cloud is rising at an advanced rate and is always at third place after AWS and Azure. No doubt, Google Cloud may surpass AWS and Azure someday, which makes it very difficult to declare one of them as the winner, as Google have many advantages over AWS, like pricings and speed. Similarly, Azure is also having many advantages over AWS. However, AWS has been a consistent pioneer in the cloud service. Its more mature infrastructure, causing less downtime each year, makes AWS a preferable choice for majority of the users. So, thank you so much for watching this session. I would love to hear from you guys that which one of them is better according to you and why. Please reply to us in the comment section below. See you again.